Hola amigos, welcome back to another episode of Regrowth with myself, Fskordok. Last episode we managed to kill Leonard, and it was a long episode. It took me a while to record and actually edit all, so I don't think I will be doing that again. So in today's episode we're gonna take it a little bit slower because there's a lot of crafting to do, and I want to build stack because we're gonna start with apply energetic and a little bit of mechanism as well. But let me show you for now some of the changes that you can see. These posts, I love them. I love the way they look. These are the acacia wood post fence, and if you take a look at post fence, you make them with just like this, a wooden axe and a birch wood, and then you put a piece of string. So it's kind of cool. They look really, really nice. Over here, as you can see, I build my house at last, and I change some of the stuff. I remove all the chests that were here the last time. This I put some vines and stuff to make it look a little prettier. We have the little river over there, and here's the house. You can see there's like a, I don't know how you call it, like a porch entrance hallway. And all around the house, here's Wilson. Hello, Wilson. I put some large flower pots all around the house. I put this because this wood irrigation channel don't connect to any other blocks. So the only block they connect is to the wooden water tank. So I put them there, and they look really nice in that way. And over here we can see this go all the way all around the house, so it's really nice. I love the look of it. I haven't finished though. If we take a look in the roof, there is no roof, so I'm still working on that roof. So don't pay attention to that weird beam over there. Over here, actually, I forgot to mention, I put one of these golem. I just realized when I started recording. Ooh, the chest is full, maybe? Yeah, wow. Bunch of stuff. Saddles, enchanted books, name tags, a lot of fish. That's really nice. This guy is fishing like crazy. It's just a regular golem that I had on the other place around, and I put a fishing core. Alright, so let's take a look at what we're gonna do today. I love these bricks, by the way. These are red rock bricks. Really easy to craft. I think I have it here. Yep, you craft them like so. And whoop. You craft them like so. Essence of fire and essence of earth. So really nice, and they look. I love how they look. And these are the slab version of them. So here I put all my chest. And all this I want to disappear because I want to build the apply energetic stuff, and we're gonna start today with that. If you take a look over here, there's a big empty area for now. I'm still working on that, so I'm gonna change all of these. I put some of the machines in here. This is the rock crusher already with power, the roller machine. The lasers, they don't have power yet, so we're gonna start with that. Here is like the back where all the cables are gonna be, so I want to separate that so I don't see a lot of cable. Here's a little entrance. Over here you go to... Hey, hello! Over here you go to the all the chest. Right here you go to the area of the all the carpenter and forestry stuff. And if we go down here, this is the under the carpentry stuff, all the machines, the pumps and stuff like that. And right here at the bottom we go where I think I showed it last time. So I have all the tanks and stuff like that. As you can see, they're coming, the steel tank is coming, a lot of fuel from the refinery I show over there. So I activate it, I throw a pipe all over from there to here. And here's still generating a lot of creosote oil, so we're gonna do probably a lot of that We're gonna try to use this. Once I have a lot more fuel, I'm gonna start using this one as well, so you have a backup, although we're not in a problem that running low on coal anytime soon. So for now, it's gonna be okay. So first thing we need to do, and I have some materials actually, let me sleep because this place is not very well lit so far. I just finished building it, so we need to still finish. So let's start with applying a energetic. And the first thing we need to do, apply energetic, is probably one of these charger. Because if we want to start, for example, with where is it? We're at MHS, we need this engineering processor, and we need an inscriber, and we need all this stuff. So let's start with some machines. Actually, this inscriber engineering press, normally when you play play energetic, you get them in chest inside like what is called, it's like a meteor. But in here, actually, it's really easy. The way you make them is you just need a chisel and a piece of iron plate. So when you put the two together, you get the inscription silicon press. If you take it out and you put it back in, you get the inscription inscriber calculation press. Then you get the engineering, and then you get the logic press, and it's cycled through them. So it's quite easy to do. Now I don't need that because I already did those. So I have one of each, and we're gonna use them to make all the stuff. But for now, first thing we need to do actually is connect these lasers. So let me, I have all the cables here, so I'm gonna connect all the lasers like this. I made a couple of more, so we have a, to try to accelerate the process. So what I want to do, the power is coming from there, and let's check that out for a second. Because they don't have, I removed the gates actually, so we need to fix that. And yeah, so let's start connecting that. And what I'm gonna do, I think, is connect it in a way that I can, right here for example, yep, I'm gonna throw the cable, let's see, let's throw the cable right there, and then we'll connect it over there, so we start receiving a bunch of power. Wow, look at that, that's probably some power left. Okay, now it's gone, that from some of this I was doing. So now let's see what we can do in here. Now let's grab a couple of basic gates for now. We'll make better gates after, but for now I'm gonna just pop some basic gates in these industrial steam engines. Yeah, they still have a power, so that's why, but let's turn them on. So what I'm gonna do is hook one up in there, and let's say if there's a power requested, so which is true right now from the lasers, for now it's an energy pulsar. Okay, we're gonna change that for iron probably and gates, but for now it's gonna be okay. What I'm gonna do, I think, is make a gate gate copier. Yeah, so wrench, let's do that one. Let's do that one, because that's gonna facilitate our work a lot. So, what was it? I need a stone gear, and I think I probably have some. I have wooden gear, okay, I have wood gear. Oh, iron gear, no. So, I need a stone gear. So, stone gear is for cobblestone. Now let's see if I find everything, because I just moved everything. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have a crafting table over here. So let's put you together like so. And we need a piece of 3 irons for that. I'm gonna grab a stack because we're gonna need it after. So let's make you like so, and we'll combine you with a piece of redstone in here, chipset, and if we combine you together we get a gate copier. So with this one, what we're gonna do is go downstairs. I'm gonna put the gates on the other machines in here. So you gonna put one over there, I'm gonna put one there, and what we're gonna do with this one is we're gonna right click, I think, yeah, copy gate information, and then shift right click on the other ones to paste the same information. So as you can see, pull requested energy cursor. It's not that difficult. I could have done it manually, but probably after, when we get some better gates. Oh, I forgot. I press. Okay, so copy gate again. So chief, right click. There you go. So now they're all working. So let's go up there, and in here, what I want to do is put a gate in there as well. Let me see here. Actually, I'm gonna use a iron gate. I have only two for now, but I'm gonna craft a lot more after. So what I'm gonna do, actually, let's do it from this side in here. So let's do you in there. And what I'm gonna say here is that because this laser drain a lot of power even if you're not using them. So I want to cut the power coming from there. So if there's a restore signal off, I'm gonna close the gate. If the restore signal is on, I'm gonna open the gate. Right, so if it's on, open the gate. Perfect. So let's do that. Put you back in there, and I need a lever. I don't have a lever there. Lever or lever? Never know. Okay, let's take a lever from there. There you go. So now, it was here? Yeah, I think it was here. So if I request something, so let's start. I want to do, and this is where I'm going to pause the video while I watch some reruns of Game of Thrones, because I haven't seen the two episodes that already started the new, so I just want to watch the other one. But what I'm going to do is put some, let's bring some materials here first. Let's bring some iron, some of you. Some gold, and we'll test this out. So I'm gonna put redstone in there, gonna put this for blue, these ones, iron, some chipset. I have some chipset here, and what else? Alright, so I wanna make a stack of iron chipset. So I'm gonna request iron chipset, and as you can see, it goes really slow for now because that's the power left, I think. If we can take a look, it's not requesting new power. So power is just using whatever is left on that those lasers. But if we flip the lever, we should get a lot more power. Well, right now they have a huge amount of power right now. So it's doing great, but it's not requesting any new power. And if we can check before we flip the lever, we can check these are all standby. So let's flip the lever and see what happens. Yeah, you see, they're dying. So now, boom, there you go. Now we receive a bunch of power. We can check, it's coming a lot of power from there. And those have to be active. Oh, they're not? Why not? Power requested, energy pulser. Yes. It's probably because... why they don't have steam? That is weird. Let me see here. Oh, rest on signal, sorry. Rest on signal. Okay, so I'm just gonna right click and paste on the other ones. There you go. And I'm gonna change this so I can turn this off probably with a better gate in the future. Because I want to check if the machine is red, is over overheating, then turn it off or something. So we're doing a bunch of chipsets, and they're going straight to here. So that's good. I'm gonna have to make more redstone. So for now, I'm gonna pause. I'm gonna make iron chipset. I'm gonna make gold chipset, at least a stack of each. I'm gonna make let me see others chipsets. Chipsets. Gold, I'm gonna make diamond, I'm gonna make quartz, redstone, no, this one no, emerald chipset, what are they used for? For emerald and gates. Okay, so maybe emerald, I'm gonna make probably 10 or 20. Quartz, I'm gonna make a lot because I'm gonna make a stack because we're gonna need it for the inscribers and stuff. And iron, we're gonna need them a lot, especially for the mechanism, this stuff we're gonna use, and this stuff we're gonna use also. I want to make a solar panel because once we get the once we get the A system running, even if we're not using it, it's still consuming power, and I want them to consume power from our solar panel. So the idea on today is mechanism. I don't know today, but we need an enrichment chamber. We're gonna make also a crusher. I want to make also what else? Let me see here. I'm gonna make these ones here, the basic energy cubes, and maybe after we'll upgrade them to store a little bit of power. And also, I want to make these puppies here, advanced solar generators. These are really, really nice, and maybe even the wind turbine. But I'm gonna start. We'll start with this one basics, then store some power, and then go and move to those one because this one used actually four of the other ones. And this is a heat generator. Oh, the only problem with the mechanism I have is they are so loud, the machine. But they are, I think, one of the best looking machines in a lot of mods, actually. So I'll give it a time, I'll watch some TV, I'll cut here, and I'll come back once I have a bunch of stack of all these silicons and stuff we're gonna make. I'll be right back. Oh, before I go, there's other stuff I want to make, and these are the basic circuit board, enhanced circuit board. There's a bunch of circuit board, and this basic, enhance, and refine are we're gonna use it a lot right now. So I'm gonna make those. What is this one? This one is for the ultimate control. We're not gonna use it for now. So I'm gonna make this basic circuit board. I'm gonna make also a stack of each for now, and these are basically like so. And if we put one in there, it's gonna make these basic ones. This one here are the with bronze, and this one here are with iron. So really basic with a little bit of water, we can make a bunch. So I'm gonna make probably a stack of each for now. So we'll see how it goes. All right, see you in a bit. Alright, so we're almost done here. I put some torches because I was AFK a lot doing this process, By the way, it took like three or four episodes of Game of Thrones to complete all the chipset. And I was trying to put some carpenters here on the marble block. As you can see, there are two different. These are the slabs and these are full bricks. And I cannot place the carpenter blocks in here and cover them with this block. It's really strange. Even the torches, if I try to put a torch here, I cannot put a torch here in this slab. I can in here, but I cannot in the other side. So that's kind of weird. So I'm gonna probably change these slabs for put it all in the same color. You see the difference here. I can put a torch here. I cannot. That's weird. In any case, another thing that we're gonna probably, I don't know if we're gonna have time on this episode or not, but I wanted to do a course of a rite of remove the curse of werewolf. Because I'm kind of tired of every full moon transforming into a wolf, so we'll probably do that. So let's continue here. Let me get rid of this for a second, and let's do what we're gonna do. So the first thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna create these steel casings. So we have three here that we're gonna use probably for maybe the bio generator, just to see how it works. But for sure, the enrichment chamber, the metallurgic infuser is the one that we're after right now. So if we put one here, we have the metallurgic infuser. That's one of the pieces that we're gonna get. And here we have these basic control circuits with these basic circuits that I just show how to craft, okay, in the carpenter. So let's take this six. And in here, I put nothing. In here, I think you have to put these three. What am I missing? We're missing something for, let me see, what was this? Use, I think it was for, oh, this advanced control circuit. So we need the enriched alloy, and that's the using the metallurgic infuser with a little bit of iron and redstone. So let's hook this up, and I'm thinking I'm gonna put it around here maybe. So let's put it here for now, and let's hook up something on the back, so to give him a little bit power. And I'm thinking I'm gonna extend it this way, because I don't want, I would love to have a way to unplug certain machines that requires a lot of power, so I'm not gonna touch it in here. And in there, I think, let me see, are you gonna get power if I connect you like this? Let's take a look. So we need a piece of iron and redstone. I think I have it here. Okay, so iron, one piece of iron and a redstone. So let's put you in there, and let's put one piece of redstone. There you go. And probably we're gonna need more than one, so let's see here. So we have this one here that we can use in this crafting recipe right here to get this one. Yeah, I'm gonna need three, so let's take two more and craft you with you. And we can close in there. I'm gonna probably make some facade for that one. So let's take you, and let's wait for the other one. Let's do some facade. I need some cobblestone, I think. Let me see here. Cobblestone pipes. Do we have some cobblestone pipes? No, we don't. So let's make one. Cobblestone. Okay. So if I put you like so. Cobblestone, and we need a little bit of gravel. Where is my gravel? Right here. So if I put you like so, yeah, we have this structure pipe. I should actually make a little bit more. There you go. And I think that with this one we can make the facade. Yes. So let me see here. Let me grab a little bit more of this. Maybe I have it in this chest. Yes, let's grab you. And let's see if we can make it in here. So if I put this in here, these are for the plugs. We can make some plugs. And this is for facade. So let's make some facades here. Okay. So let's take the facades. And we can put a facade right here, maybe. Can I put you there? No, probably not. So let me open this one for a second and see if I can put you there. Yeah, much better. All right, so let's take you and make two more of this. Three will be enough. So now we can put these two in here. And this was for what we're doing here, for one of the blue chips. So we need a reinforced alloy. It's one of the U with a piece of diamond. Okay, so let's take one diamond and we can crush it here. Let me remove this. I was doing some surface quartz, so let's crush it. Oh, we cannot use U. Huh. Okay. So why we cannot use U? Let's see here. Use diamond dust. We need a grindstone or a crusher. Okay, let's see. We have the crusher. Let me see if we can make the crusher. Where's the crusher? Right here. So two greens, iron chipset, a little bit of lava. Okay, so let me grab the materials for that. I'll be right back. Alright, so we have everything we need. I wanted to show you this one also. This we can use it, the quartz grindstone. You can craft it like that, and you need a wooden crank. And this normally is an early game machine that doesn't require power. And let me put you right here for now. So you put the crank on the top, like so. And then you put whatever you want to grind. This is a nice... Oh, we cannot use it there. Jeez. Okay, so we cannot use this one. But normally you can use it with some ores. It's an early game in all the other packs, but this one, not so much. Let me see. Can I have some ores? Let me grab some of you. And just demonstrate really quick this one. So let's put you like so, and let's see if we can use you. So if I put a little bit of here, you right click in there and then you crank this with the mouse, and then it will become like this, and then it will become dust, I guess, normally. I don't know, I haven't tried it on this pack. Yeah. And then you just double your ore and you can use that to smelt and everything. So it's kind of a cool way to double your ore early games. This was cooking some silicon. So as you can see, this one become an ingot. And it's nice to double the ores like that. But for now, let's keep going on this one, I think. I put everything here, so we're gonna need two of you. Then if I put you like so, we have the crusher. Now let's grab and put the crusher in here maybe. So let's add a little bit of power there. Okay, and like so. I'm just curious to see if... Okay, so just a little bit of power, but what I'm paying attention here, if there is a machine that constantly drain power, like for example the lasers. That's why I need some kind of indication if it's not draining power. If it is, then we need to do something like we did on the lasers, like here on this. And as you can see, even if I interrupt the lasers, I just interrupting this branch here. I'm not interrupting like this branch here. I'm not interrupting the power coming to other machines. So that's what's cool about it. So let's put then you in here. And look at the animation on that one. I love it. I really like Mekanism machine. They're very cool designs. All right, so we have some diamond dust, and what are we? We were gonna use it in here, I think. So let me see. Use. Okay, yes, yeah, so we're doing some of this. So let me. Oh, I need another of those. Okay, so I need a little bit of iron and redstone dust. So you and you. And let's put you in there. And then we'll use you with a little bit of redstone dust. There you go. We put you back in there and a little bit of diamond dust. And then we get what we're doing. Kind of lost track of what we're doing. So apply energetic, but we're doing this reinforced alloy. And I think you can go in here. There you go, to get the blue elite control suite. And then with you, we can put you in here and in here to get the charger. Perfect, finally. It's take a long time, it's a long process to do this. So now with the charger, we can. Does the charger require power? I think it does. So I'm gonna put you for now in here. And let's put a little bit of a cable in there. Let's see how it goes. So I don't want to charge you like this. Maybe from the bottom. I don't know if, well, for now we'll decorate after. So let's take a look. We need some of these surgical quartz. So let's charge you to test it. So we put you in there. And you're not receiving any RF. So, okay, so you're not connected. So probably you have to be... Okay, let me take you out. Gonna put... Let me put you actually in here for now. And see if you can charge from the bottom. Yes, okay, you're charging from the bottom there. So now you should be charging. There you go, perfect. Ooh, shocking. All right, so this is one way. And then we wait for a second. You haven't charged yet. There you go. Okay, it takes a little bit of time. There you go. But now we have three charged Surtur Quartz crystal. Do I have any other recipe here that was working? No. Oh, this one. This one is for the inscriber. Yeah. The inscriber that we need to do. Let me see here. Okay, we need a flux crystal, and for this one, I think it is drop one charge of surface quartz. That's why we did all that. One nether quartz and a little bit of redstone into a puddle. So I'm probably gonna do this a lot of times, but for now, let's use three of you and three of you in a little bit of water. So where do we have water here? Okay, this will work. Okay, so what we need to do is drop these three in there. I'm gonna get out of there. There you go. All right, so let's see if we can put all of you in there. I'm gonna take out because I still have my magnet on. But it should work. There you go. We have six of you, and we can use you to create the inscriber. So let's go back in here, put one of you there, and we have the inscriber finally. All right, so let me put you, I'm gonna put you in there as well. I'm gonna probably arrange this a little better. I don't like the way, even if we can put some covers to make it look better. I'm probably gonna change that. There you go. So that's not bad actually. Yeah, I don't have access to there. Okay, that's not bad. So in here we can use it to get that of the, for example, the silicon. And if I put the silicon there, I think. Let me see what we need now. We're gonna need this inscriber calculation press, of course. So we can use, for example, achievement get. Okay, we can use the inscriber, the silicon, I think, with a little bit of how this works. Okay, let me see the uses. Okay, so inscriber silicon press with a little bit of silicon and printed silicon. Why is it not working? Oh, it takes a little bit. Okay, so a little bit after we got the printer silicon, so we need to do that a bunch of times, of course. So let's put, oh, one by one. Okay, I cannot put more. All right, this stack. All right, so that's the inscriber silicon press. Now we have a bunch of others. What we want to do, for example, at the beginning probably will be, let me see here. It would probably be a good idea to make some kind of ME controller, not need now. This will be nice, the growth acceleration. So what we need to do is a bunch of cables. And let's take a look. This, where's the energy? Probably pass it already. ME interface, this is a crafting unit. Let me see, where are you? Don't even remember the name, that's why. Energy acceptor, there you go. So iron, quartz. So let's do that one, because with that one we can actually grab some. Oh, we have a zombie. Okay, let me sleep. Let me go to sleep. There you go. So let's see here. Energy acceptor. Where do I have a zombie? It's right there. Oh yeah, they're burning in the sun. Okay. So let's use you like so probably. Or the other way around. Yeah, probably the other way around. Okay. So let's use you like so. There you go. So let's grab a recipe for that and do, I don't know, 12 for now. And with that one, we can use it. Now I lost it again. Acceptor. Okay, we need one pure and four iron. Do I have iron? No, I don't. So let's grab you and make you one energy acceptor. Perfect. So with this one, we can connect it and let's say put it right there for now. I'm going to change all this, but if I put you there, are you getting power? No, of course not. Let me grab you and put you in there. So now with this one, I can actually hook up power to the machines. So if I made, for example, the ME driver, we're going to need the engineering processor. We're going to need two of those. So printer, engineer circuits. We have these. With this one, we need the diamond electron tubes. And this one is in thermionic fabricator, actually. And I was making those. So let's go over here. Thermionic fabricator. As you can see, I have a bunch here already to go. And we're going to have to wrap up and continue in the next episode very, very soon. Just wanted to finish a little bit of this. So let's see here. The printed. So we need a diamond chipset. So let me grab two diamond chipsets. One, two. The emeralds, I just made six. I don't think we're going to be using a lot of those anyway. So, okay. So if we put the diamond, how was it? Let me see. Where are you? Okay, So diamond, silicon, and this one. So we need to make this one here. So we need the inscriber engineering press. So the inscriber engineering press here with you. Sorry about that. Are you receiving power? You're not. Okay. Why you're not receiving power? Oh, because I destroy you. All right. One, two. All right, so I'll remove you. I'll put you in there with you in there and a little bit of diamond chipset. There you go, and engineering processor. So we need to do that once more. There you go. And I'm gonna craft a bunch of engineering processors and the silicons and all the processors that we're gonna use, so we don't have to do this again while we're creating all the machines for ME. Okay, so these two are done, and with a little bit of iron. So now we need these quartz fibers, really easy to make. So let's do those, and I'm gonna, do I have more? Yes, I have more glass and I have more of you. So I'm gonna put you like so, whoops. Something like that, I think it was. Yes. So we're gonna grab six of you and where are you? Okay, and then we need to combine it with two of these. So you like so and like so, no? Oh, don't tell me we need yeah, quartz fiber, fluid crystal, pure fluid crystal. Like that. Okay. There you go. We have four. And now with a little bit of diamond we can do you. Perfect. We have our first machine. So this machine we can put it like here, and as you can see it won't connect to this one, but it will connect to that one if I put a cable, and that will give it power. But of course we need an ME drive, so we're gonna leave it like that. We're gonna start creating our drivers, because we need now we need a logical processor. That's same process as we have done the other ones. Now we need a golden chipset, and this one needs a golden electron tube that is the same as the diamond but with gold in the thermionic fabricator over there. So with that, let me grab a little bit of gold from here, make a bunch of those, let me show you very quick, and then we cut there, and let me put you in here, and we'll change, there you go, we'll change you like so, and we can make a bunch of these guys for the other ones. So with that guys, I'll leave you there, and we're gonna start the next episode probably at the beginning with the rite of remove a curse, so I don't become a werewolf every time at night, and then continue with this technology pad to get ourselves all the A network ready. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and thank you so much for all the supports and new subscribers to the channel, and see you next time. Take care, have a nice day, bye bye!